black and white and pissed all over.
A penguin that got into a pirate's stash of rum.
Wow! Wow! Seriously, that was impressive. No, okay, so it is the giant panda. So, in order to introduce giant panda cubs into the wild, the researchers at China's Wolong Nature Reserve, they dressed as adult pandas, and they covered themselves in panda pee. Why might they do that?
Because they're perverts. Watching panda porn all night. Which is a very slow watch, I have to say.
It's nothing to do with settling the young ones in the wild, is it?
Yes. Here's the thing about the pandas. They look very cute, but let's remember the bear part of their name.
Yeah.
They are still aggressive, and you don't want them to go into villages and go, oh, those nice people. So they wanted them to feel that they were with actual pandas, and the way to do that is to cover them in the panda urine so they don't smell of human beings. The extent to which it's related to the red panda, that's been debated backwards and forwards, but it isn't really. The giant panda is a bear. The red panda is closer to a raccoon. But they have recently discovered why they've got black and white fur.
Oh.
The black bits help to camouflage them in the summer, and the white bits help to camouflage them in the winter. And it was discovered by a guy called Tim Caro. He's a University of California biologist. And he's the same researcher who spent 10 years working out why zebras are black and white.
Yeah.
Yes. So it's probably to deter flies, who, for some reason that is unclear, do not like landing on striped surfaces. Oh, no, I'm not going down there. Yeah.
I've been to Africa and I saw plenty of flies around the zebras.
Yes, but they don't land.
Oh, they don't
land. Yeah, they spin around going, has anybody seen a horse, a plain horse? I don't
know. It's another thing, if you take a zebra to a supermarket and you fire a barcode gun at it, it says zebra.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.